We covered the basics of motion tracking before, but you often need to take it beyond the basics, and that's what we're looking at today, specifically with Mocha AE, which comes included in After Effects. We have this green screen card here that we intend to replace with something better. Yeah, like that. And to accomplish this, you don't necessarily need to use green, although it is very helpful if you have something crossing that area during the shot, but really you just need something that has contrast from your background so that Mocha will have an easier time providing an accurate track. So with our clip inside of After Effects, we're gonna go to Effect, Boris, Effects, Mocha, and tap on Mocha AE. Now in your effect controls, tap this logo to launch Mocha AE. Inside of Mocha, go to the beginning of your clip, then up to the toolbar and select this X-spline layer tool to create a new spline and start to mask out the board. Once you have that masked, tap the Show Planar Surface button and align each corner to your object. Having this blue square cover the object proportionally is key, so don't fuck it up. Do a good job. Then down under Motion, make sure you have all these boxes checked. And with those set, tap the Track Forward button and Mocha will now track your clip. If it loses the track, once the angle of the board changes, pause the track, then under Search Area, raise the angle to around 5 degrees to give Mocha a heads up that your object will rotate a bit. And if you don't see this option, change your workspace to Classic. Once that's done, tap this Show Planar Grid button and review your track to make sure everything is looking solid. If you notice any drifting, adjust your track points and track frame by frame for the areas that are giving you trouble. Once you're done with that, tap the Save button in the upper left corner and head back to After Effects. The next step here is to prep the image or video that's going to be tracked into the card. And there's two important things to note here. First, make sure that the layer you're adding has the same aspect ratio as your tracking object. And two, your composition dimensions all have to be the same, regardless of the size of your object. So we're gonna bring in the image that we want to track onto the board in our main comp, right click, and tap Pre-compose. Rename your file so we can easily keep track of it. We'll name ours Overlay, then tap Move All Attributes to New Composition. Double check that both comps have the same dimensions, then go inside your Overlay comp, right-click your image, go to Transform, and select Fit to Comp. This may distort your image, especially if you're tracking something for an iPhone screen, but that will be corrected shortly. Now go back to your main comp, select your clip layer, then under Tracking Data, you're going to tap Create Track Data. Next to Export Option, select Corner Pin, supports Motion Blur, and next to Layer Export 2, you're going to select your Overlay Comp. Finally, tap Apply Export, and you should have a solid replacement here. The last thing that needs to be done is to reveal the hands that are holding the board, so we're going to move the Overlay Comp underneath our clip, select the clip, then go to Effects, Keying, and drop on Key Light. Select your screen color, change your view to screen matte, and adjust your settings until your key area is solid black. We did another episode all about keying, so if you want more information on that, check the links below. But once you're done, set your view to final result and you should have this. But there you have an example of some advanced motion tracking inside of After Effects. This exact method can be used to replace pretty much anything you want. Just make sure, as always, that while you're filming, you are planning for post, making sure that the object you need to track will be easily trackable, and you know if you are going with a key or roto. The success of any VFX shot really does lean heavily on your planning in advance. But that's it for today. If you have any questions or a topic that you would like to see us cover, let us know in the comments below. And subscribe to the channel for more updates and tutorials like this one, because a cow-bison hybrid is called a beefalo. I'm not lying. Look it up.